Jorge Blanco's naked body was slumped in the middle of the empty, unlit bullring. He was curled into a ball, his legs tucked underneath his body, and a pair of bright yellow and red banderilla darts hung from the center of his back, their sharp fishhook points ripping at his flesh as they flopped to the ground. Higher up, towards his shoulders, a red-handled matador sword had been thrust into his ribcage, still swaying as the upper half of the blade caught glimmers of the streetlights outside. A Spanish national flag was tied around his neck like a noose, and lay mingling with congealed dark black bloodstains in the sand. Cámara felt an icy weight sink in his guts and a fierce electric buzz beginning to crawl up his spine. The municipal who had brought him here was coughing and hacking some yards behind, trying not to throw up. Outside in the streets, cars streamed past and Fallas music blared, the city still unaware of the storm about to break over the cold corpse curled up at its heart. Cámara's phone bleeped. It was the duty officer back at the Jefatura. "The científicos are on their way," he told him. "Pardo?" Cámara asked. "He's been informed. You're the nearest officer to the scene." There was a pause. No need to say it, but the duty officer felt compelled to spell it out. "It's your murder, Cámara,"